Hi everybody, my name is Lyndon, and in this video we're going to do another type of text reveal using a luma mat, but instead of using stock footage or using a mask, we're going to do it with the fractal noise effect. It's going to be a really, really short, quick video, but it is a useful effect. So, make a new composition, full HD, 30 FPS, 150 frames. I'm going to make some text. I'm going to send another text in frame. Okay, so after we've made the text, the first thing, right click on your composition, we're going to go and add a new solid. It's going to be called our fractal mat. Doesn't matter what the color is because we're adding a fractal noise effect. Okay, so this effect gives us like randomized patterns essentially. There's lots of different effects that you can choose from, different presets. We've got some turbulent smooth, this is what it looks like. It looks like kind of blobby with a lot of just different grain in between. We've got dynamic, which is very cloudy, and this is one of the more common types that I would use. And then we have quite a few other ones, with like string shaped ones. We have ones that are more rocky, and on even the ones that are basic, we can change the noise type to be block, so we get like a much more digital looking effect. And you can even do things like this spline one, which is a bit more smooth than the soft linear, has less contrast. It doesn't particularly matter which one you choose, and on any one of these fractal noise effects, you can add a number of other different effects to kind of enhance the shape, and one of them is going to be CC vector blur, and that can drastically change the aesthetics of the effect. So for this, I'm just going to switch this back to dynamic, and then I'm going to set the contrast to be a little bit higher, something like 200. Now you can do this with the curves or levels or any other type of color correction tool, but since this is built in, we're just going to use that. So the first thing here, we're going to make the brightness be much darker until the entire canvas is black. It's going to be around 150 or 140, I guess, here. Set the stopwatch on brightness at frame 0, then go forward to the end frame, and then change that to positive 140. So these numbers here for the brightness are going to depend on the type of fractal noise that you're using, but just do it high enough until it's black at the beginning and white at the end, or vice versa. Black will mean that it's not going to be showing up at all, and then white means everything will be showing up. And you don't have to just do this with text, it works with any pixels. So on your fractal reveal text, set the track mat to luma mat. And as we scrub between this, you can see that fractal, the actual text fractal, is being revealed, but it's revealed in a more organic way. So we don't have any linear wipe, we don't have any masks being used, and we don't need any other element to be able to control it. It's simply this fractal noise effect. Okay, so the next thing, if you want to just expand upon this a little bit, we'll go to the evolution settings of the fractal noise effect. Hold down the Alt key, select the stopwatch for evolution. This allows us to input an expression. So we can say time multiplied by however many degrees we want that to rotate per second. So I could say something like 360. So every second, I want that to go one full revolution. That's going to wobble a little bit. If that's a little bit too fast, maybe half that. So that might be more of what you're going for, something that's not as static and does wobble a little bit. So another thing that you can do with this would be to turn this back on just so we can see what the mat is doing. And we can leave that on dynamic, change the noise type to block, and we can just kind of see how that's moving and see what effect that gives us. So perhaps you wouldn't want to use that with the evolution, maybe you do. You could also really easily use this with a displacement map. So if you wanted to add a displacement map, what you can do is add a new adjustment layer, call this displacement, and add a displacement map effect. So for the displacement map layer, we're going to use the fractal mat, source effects and masks, and then from there we can see that it's going to distort a little bit. It's going to wobble along with that mat. So as it's being revealed, that mat is also kind of shifting those pixels. Gives us a little bit more of an interesting design. One more thing that I'd like to show you. Let's turn the displacement back off, go back to the fractal mat. So instead of using blocky, I'll change this back to maybe a spline. We have a very cloudy looking map here. There's an effect called vector blur, and vector blur is very, very useful. It can very easily create more of like a energy looking effect if you increase the amount, or more of a crystallized look. And we can get some like maybe kaleidoscope looking elements there. But if I reset this and go to direction fading, we can very easily make this very cloudy, like some kind of particles in water. So with the evolution, this would give us a much softer look on our mat. Let's turn this back off. I could turn the displacement back on if I wanted to, and then I could play this forward. So this is very similar to that ink reveal that we did. And so this is gonna give you a much softer looking type of fractal reveal. Just depends on the aesthetic that you're going for. So I hope you find that useful. If you did, subscribe, and I hope to have some more videos out shortly. All right, so thanks for watching and have a good day.